We shall now explain the marks that are on your holy garment, the same marks are on the veil. Here we have the mark of the compass, signifying that all truth may be circumscribed into one great whole. Over here, we have on this breast the mark of the square, signifying that all things are done in proper rectitude and with rightness and completeness. Here we have the navel mark, signifying that there's a belly button there. And here we have the knee mark, signifying that every knee shall bow and every tongue confess that Jesus is the Christ. Now, if you'll turn around, here we have the flap. And I'll say no more about the flap. We do know that Mormon women are taught that it is probably not a sin, but it's still not really cool if you have sex with your garments off. And so, if you'll notice, the flap goes all the way up to here. And so many Mormon women brag about the fact that their children were conceived with their garments on. So they have sex with their garments on. Now, is that a drag or what?
Show us the hatchery.
In the Mormon temple, you were taught all of the various. They are called signs and tokens that will allow one to enter into the presence of God and forever be a member of the celestial kingdom. The first token of the Aaronic priesthood is done with the knuckle of the right thumb over the first knuckle of the right hand of that one receiving it in this manner. We desire all to receive it. The name of that first token of the Aaronic priesthood is your own given name.
Your first name, which is? Toad!
There's a sacred token named Toad. Alright. This is called the sign of the nail, signifying that the nail is driven through the palm of Christ. This is known as the first token of the Melchizedek priesthood, or the sign of the nail. It has a name. The name of this token is the Son, meaning the Son of God. Now finally we come to the second token of the Melchizedek priesthood, the patriarchal grip, or the sure sign of the nail, which is done by clasping the right hands, interlocking the little fingers, with the index finger in the center of the palm in this manner. This is the second token of the Melchizedek priesthood, the patriarchal grip, or the sure sign of the nail. It does have a name, but it will not be given you at this point, but it shall be given you hereafter. It's long, and it's laborious, and it's boring as hell, this name, this token. Here are the penitents. The sign of the token of the first Aaronic priesthood is given by raising the right arm to the square with the thumb extended in this manner. Then, by placing the right thumb under the left ear, we say, I, Toad, will never reveal the first token of the Aaronic priesthood. Rather than do so, I will suffer my life to be taken. And we do what? The true order of prayer. The true order of prayer. We ask six or seven couples to arise. Each of you will clasp the right hand of the person next to you in the patriarchal grip, or the sure sign of the nail, placing your left arm on the arm or the shoulder of the person next to you in this manner. In the temple. Now then, we do lay, lay, nail. Lay, lay, nail. Lay, hail, signifying, O God, hear the words of my mouth, and hear the decree of my time, my three times, O to the veil. The worker will tap three times to the mallet. Tap, tap, tap. Nobody. Why three times? And why a mallet? After the tap three times with the mallet, the Lord marks the veil and asks, what is wanted? What is wanted? He, having been true and faithful in all things, desires further light and knowledge by speaking with the Lord through the veil. You shall receive it, you call the five points of fellowship through the veil. The five points of fellowship are inside of right foot, by the side of right foot, knee to knee, hand to breast,
hand
to back, breast to breast, and mouth to ear at the this point, God says to that person coming to the veil to enter the celestial kingdom, this is the name of the token. Help the navel, narrow your bones. Strike the loins and your sinews. Power of the priesthood. Be upon me and my posterity. Through all generations of time and throughout all eternity. At this point, the back up, God, and get your hands off your ass. At this point, the person is then presented to the veil, and the worker taps three times with the mallet. God breaks the veil and says, as he wants it, Eve, having conversed with the Lord, desires now to enter his presence. Let her enter. God then stretches forth his right hand and draws that person into heaven, where they shall entertain eternal bliss forever and ever in the presence of God, his holy angels, and all of those who have been initiated into bliss.
Blessing on the bread. O Rod, the eternal phallus, we task thee in the name of thy main one, squeeze us twice, to blast and pacify this dread to the souls of all those who fake part of it, that they may retreat in resemblance of the rod of thy main one, and finesse unto thee, O Rod, the eternal phallus, that they are thrilling to go down upon them in the fame of thy main one, and always dismember him and jeep his commandos which he has driven them, that they may always have his spirit decor to be with them. Amen.
Now we shall breast the water, the water.
O Jelohim, the infernal father, we flask thee in the name of thy son, Jello Christ, bless and sanctify these shooters to the souls of all those who drink from them, that they may do it in remembrance of the wine of thy son, which was fermented for them, that they may always remember him, that they may have his spirit to be with them. Amen.
And God saith, go thou therefore and be thou shit-faced.